We are going to discuss about the psychoanalytic theory. After psychoanalytic theory, I am focusing on psychosexual theory. Just two theories made by the great psychologist. He is called as a modern psychologist also. The father of modern personality theories, as well as modern psychologist. Like this, he's having plenty of names is there. As well as he's not directly committed to the psychologist. He's basically from the medical doctor. He's in doctor background. From his observation only, he made the tremendous contributions in the case of the personality. And most of the people, some of the people, even some of the followers of him, they are opposing his theory, particularly in the sexual theory and all, a lot of people are opposing. That is why it's called as a new Freudian theory. New Freudian theory means some of the followers of the Freudian, they may accept some of the good things about his theory. And apparently they are opposing some unwanted things, some kind of theories, aspects of the Freud, they opposed. Therefore, that people may call as a neo-Freudian. That also I may focus, who are the called as neo-Freudian, that also I may focus on. Yes. Before going to this psychoanalytic theory, just I'm going to highlight the previous things. Still now we are discussing about the three important basic theories. One is the type theory, trait theory, then now I am moving to the psychoanalytic theory. What is the exact difference among the three? For that, I am just highlighting the same image which I already used this one. In the case of type approach, we may call them as a so there is a two girl, boy and so one boy and girl. In the case of the Sanjay, we may call in the name of type approach called chloric, then mesomorphic. In the case of the Sweta, his behavior, it's replicate the melancholic. So in this manner, we can categorize the people because it's called as a type approach. So there is a physical appearance. Parallelly, there is an association happened with the temperament. Based on this, the people are dividing with some kind of specific characteristic personality. Therefore, the Sweta may come with melancholic personality. The Sanjay is coming with chloric and mesomorphic. In the case of the trait approach, here we are not talking, we are not categorizing the people, but here we are going to check the temperament level one. The temperament, when you look onto the temperament level of the Sanjay, we may feel that he may aggressive characteristics much. He's always a hot temper, that's why he may beat her. And he's an undisciplined. So this issue, this is where we have to find the person's trait with the use of the trait approach. But in the case of the psychoanalytic theory, this and psychoanalytic theory I'm going to focus here, it's talking about the mind, whether he's having the conscious mind or unconscious mind. And generally, in the conscious mind and unconscious mind, we can use a different terminology in the case of psychoanalytic theory. In the case of the unconscious mind, we can use the name as an id. So because he's not normal, he's always expecting to fulfill his needs immediately. So like he's always feel too comfortable with his belonging things, as well as what are things he's thinking immediately he want to implement. That kind of adamant nature he's having. That's called desire fulfillment. That kind of nature he's having. That is why these people may treat it as unconscious and it may come to the heat. And one more thing. In the case of the psychoanalytic theory, it adds for all the people because each of the individual having the ego and superego. The level only may vary. But in the previous cases, the case of type approach, once you combine the people, once you divide the people as a mesomorphic, it may be mesomorphic one. Or if you go with the endomorphic, it's the endomorphic only. So because the categories differ. But in this case, the psychoanalytic theory, each one's having the three levels of the personality. One is the id, ego and superego. These are three things all the people's having. Which one is dominating? Based on this only, our personality may and display to others. So our personality is made because of the three things, id, ego and superego. These things only I'm going to be highlight here. Before that, just I'm going to highlight the some of the brief history about the Sigmund Freud. So he was born in 6 May 1956. He was died in 23rd September 1939 in the age of 83. He is basically from Austria. His field is in neurology. So I already mentioned that he's crossed lot of mental patients. So, okay, those are having some kind of mental issues, psychological issues. they may approach him. So because he's a doctor, from his observations only, he write lot of articles as well as the books. One of the books, it's a well-known books, that is called Interpretation of Dreams. If you possibly can find that book from the net source, or you can buy this book, because he is discussing a lot of things. Even for each dreams, in the morning we are getting some dreams, in the sense there is a unique meaning in this. So like this, he is giving a lot of interpretations of the people's dreams and all. It's a good book. And one more good thing about the book, in the sense, in all the languages it will be translated. Even it will be available in Malayalam language, Hindi language, and Tamil language. All the languages this book is available. The book is called Interpretations of the Dreams. If possible, you can find and read the book. And he's a psychotherapy, psychoanalysis. He's an alma mater, University of Vienna. This is a brief introduction about him. He's having the plenty of followers, because even he's not directly with psychologists, but his contributions, no? Lot of psychologists, they like to incorporate to him. That's why they call Jung and Adler. They are always accepting the lot of good things about his theory. Apparently, they are opposing also. That's another story. And he's the father of the modern psychology, the Freud. And these are the books he wrote by himself. And some of the books should be translated with other people's and all. See, this is a book so I told you, The Interpretation of Dreams, the complete and definite text. So each dreams having the unique meaning. Suppose the morning you are getting some dreams, the midnight you are getting some dreams, in the sense, he's given the different kind of interpretation for this. So, but nowadays, whether it may apt or not, it's a hypothetical question only, because the previous, he did the things more than 15 years before. Whether that theories may apt now, in the sense, it's a 100 million questions only. But apparently, we can appreciate his talent because more than 50 years before itself, he attempted a good things. He writes an interpretations about each of the person's dreams. So it's a great move. And he's most of the theory why the people are against him, in the sense, because he's always connecting with the people's personality with the sexual instincts and all. That's why some of the psychology, they are against his approaches. So, but that is why you can see some of the books, he may focus much on the sexuality and the psychology of love and psychoanalysis theory. This is his own book written, but it's translated book of the Interpretation of Dreams. That's why I told in all the languages, his books should be available. Kindly find if you're having any scope in the sense. And this is the book, Meet the Ego, Super Ego, is written by the Sigmund Freud, but after that edited by the Ernest Jones. This was another book. This is the way he categorized the people's people's personality, and all the people having the ego, super ego. See, Freud, his work was not based on the empirical research. He's not doing any kind of empirical research in it, but on his observations and case studies of his patients and others. So his ideas are often viewed with this skepticism. Freud was an enormously profile. He's a protective thinker also, and his theories are still considered important. Even he's not directly with psychology, but his theory, because he that's called direct experience he got. So he faced a lot of problematic peoples, delinquent people, mental retarded people. From his observation of the patients, he wrote a very good article as well as the essays, then books. From those books only, now we came to know that, oh, he divided the people's things based on the conscious and unconscious. Like that, he wrote a very wonderful insight, his insight only, but based on the real experiences. And Freud personality theory was influenced by early ideas about the mind working at conscious and unconscious level. Freud, actually, he believed that early childhood experiences are filtered through the ego and superego. It is the way the individual handles this experience, both consciously as well as the unconsciously. These two things only shape the personality of the adulthood. So in the childhood days, how you can effectively control the id, how you can lead the superego, or how you can use the ego, based on this only, your adulthood personality may decide. So like this is some kind of strong belief. So he made the personality to build around the three unified and interrelating systems, namely id, superego, and ego. So this middle part is called ego. This ego is acted as a policeman, because the id is talking about the basic instinct. Okay, so whenever sometimes you can find the id characteristics much in the children's, those who are within 2 years childs, no, you can find the much id characteristics. In the case of the superego, you can find some of the adulthood people. They always thinking about the moral and values only. They mean lies with aligned with moral and ethics only. That people is called as a superego. I'm going to tell one example. What is the difference between ego and superego? In my child, so I have the 3 years, 3.5 years old child. We go to the shop, now immediately she asking to buy chocolate. So here the chocolate is a basic instinct for the children's, the chocolate. What it means, so immediately they seek, whenever we go outside, immediately they thought to be eat some chocolates. That is the eat character, that is called desire characteristics. So they want to fulfill the desires, the happiness. We need to get the instinct of happiness. That's why my child is forcing me to buy the chocolate. But what I'm thinking, so normally I'm thinking that this chocolate is not good for the health. So it's better not to buy the chocolate. Like that I am thinking. Okay, so that is called our natures. We are thinking about the eye level. So we are thinking about the future issues of the child. Like this, we are thinking in the name of the child wellness only. But in the case of my first child, she's having the years, 7 years old. She's studying the first standard. Once my child, the small child, is forcing me to buy the chocolate, no? She may force me to buy the chocolate, big chocolate. But my small child, no? The 7 years old child, he may tell me that, Appa, better to buy a small chocolate instead of a big one. So she's having idea that the chocolate is not good for the health. But apparently she could understand that she needed chocolate. But she's not forced me to buy a very big chocolate. She's telling to buy a small chocolate. So this is called ego. So in this ego, it lies in between the id and superego. Generally, the small children's home, the birth child, they have the very big level of id characteristics. This is the image is talking about the id, ego, superego. Normally, the unconscious mind, we cannot be show regularly the unconscious mind to anyone. That id characteristics, no, always comes down only. Sometimes the ego may compress the id characteristics, called the superego. So therefore, we may use the term conscious mind as the ego. Pre-conscious mind is a superego. Unconscious mind is an id. So these two things you already familiar. Just I'm going to the current example. This is an example is had for my case. Just I'm using some mobile symbol, how the ego, id and superego may leads me. So I choose to explain this id, ego, superego for this particular example. I think I'm worst control, self-control with the use of the mobile phone usage. But generally we have the broad vision that don't use much mobile devices because make the people too addict. That is called superego. So we are thinking about the ethics and all. But apparently the ego is telling that at least I can use for only the education purpose. I'm not using much on that. Like that I have to take a decision as an ego. But the id, you know, sometimes when traveling or sometimes whenever I feel alone, immediately I may open my camera. So open my mobile phone and watching some films. I'm spending much time in this mobile phone because I don't have control to use the mobile phone. But I feel that whenever looking at the mobile phone, I may get some kind of relaxation. I may happy like that. I feel for fulfilling that happiness, I'm always using the mobile phone. So it means I don't have self-control to stop the usage of the mobile phone usage. So this is way our ego and superegos to be showcased in each and every activities of our day-to-day life. Then another example, in the id and superego may influence on the egos much. See this case, the id, I already highlighted that it's a pleasure needs only. I want to do that now. Immediately I had to do like that only the id may think. But in the case of superego, it's so that no, it is not fair. Don't do it because it's not be fair. It's may harmful to others. Likely the superego may direct me. So in the previous 10 year or 15 years before, no, the lot of old films, they have some kind of manasarcha. I don't know whether the Malayalam the term is there. One person may sing. Apparently the same person's the shadow. It comes and talk to them or speak and sing a song. So that kind of manasarcha, like our internal feeling, no, that is called as a superego. That we have the two different opinions. Whenever you're thinking about anything, no, any incident, we have the two or three ideas may come, or two or three opinions may come in our mind. That opinion, some opinion may be id characteristic, some opinion may be ego characteristic, some opinion may be superego. So we have to classify, and that opinion, which is much implement or much influence on us, then sometimes. Most of the time, the id may win because the most of the time superego may lose, because we need to get the pleasure only. That is our ideology. That is why most of the time the id leads. And apparently, the id, if having much in the sense, your personality, it's in very hypothetical questions only, because a lot of issues and the other people may face because of your personality, because it's in this. And in this case, I want to do it now. In the case of it, the superego, it is not right to do that. But the ego feel that maybe we can compromise. So at least we can compromise with this issue like this. We can come for some kind of neutral judgment in it. That's why I told her, my first child, the small child, 3 years old, she's asking to buy a big chocolate. For me, I believe that no need to buy a chocolate. It's not good for the health. That is called superego. My first child, 7 years old, she is thinking that she needs a chocolate, but not a big one. It's better to small one, because she knows that the chocolate is not harmful to health. It's harmful to health. Apparently, she likes to fulfill this pleasure. That is why the ego can lead here the neutral role in this. Just I'm going to highlight what is it, ego, superego, one by one. The earliest part of the personality to emerge is the id only. The id is the presence of birth and runs on the pure instinct, desire and need. It is entirely unconscious and encompasses the most primitive part of the personality, including the basic biological factors and reflexes. So here, see here, they exist entirely in the unconscious mind. Our hidden true, normally the id we may treat it as animal characteristics, animalistic ones. That is called desire things. Work on the pleasure seeking principle. Always it's working with the, checking with the pleasures only, pleasure seeking principle. Which are the activity it make them to be pleasure, that things only they this id can do it. That is the main problem in the case of the id. Then it has no values, no laws followed, not rules, does not recognize right or wrong. So here, they don't think about any kind of moral things or ethics things. They need to fulfill this basic instinct. So they always move to the instinct things only. They don't find what is correct, what is good, wrong and all. And avoid pain and receive the instant happiness. That's main problem for them. They eat the things. It's always getting the happiness, instant happiness, to avoid the pains. These are the issues in the case of the eat. Only considers the satisfaction of eating it. And also the id people, so they may think about by themselves only. They are not thinking about others and all. The id is motivated by the pleasure principle, which want to gratify all the impulses immediately. If its needs aren't met, it creates tensions normally. However, because all desires cannot be fulfilled right away, those needs may be satisfied at least temporarily. Though primary process thinking in which the individual fantasies about what they desire. So this is the biggest problem in the case of the id. Next, this is another slide. It's talking about the characteristics of the id. See the id, I'm just explaining like this. Id, I demand, I desire, I destroy. So these are the basic thought it's having by the id people, id much people in the sense. And do you know the term idiot? The term the idiot may, I hope it may frame from the word id only. And there is a man idioming, I hope you may hear the person's idioming. So he's the man to eat the men's flesh and also he's very crucial man. He's in basically from Uganda. his name is EDMA. So even his name EDMA in also may come from id, I think so. So because the id represent the desired characteristics, demand characteristics, immediately they want to fulfill. That's the thing they may take care decisions, the lead people. And I already mentioned that main principles to be pleasuring only. Then second one is called ego. The second part of the personality is called ego. That arises from the id, after this only it comes. Even the after the second year, so hopefully in the second year onwards, the child may develop some kind of ego things. It is a job is to acknowledge, deal with the reality. They may think about the reality, ensuring that it impulses are regained and expressed in a way that are socially acceptable. So they may get some kind of neutral. Normally, in the case of ego, is acted as a policeman to control the basic instinct of the id. And that role the ego is doing. The ego operates from the reality principle. It may focusing on the reality principle, which is real, which is good, that only it may doing in the case of the ego, which works to satisfy the id desires in the most reasonable and realistic way. The ego may do this by delaying gratifications, sometimes compromising or anything else that will avoid the negative consequences of going against the society's norms and rules. So this is a role normally the ego is doing. Ego function, I already mentioned, is like as a policeman, and it check whether any unlawful activities by the id is going to be happening, doesn't may stop. Then it follows the principles of reality, act with the intelligence to control, select and decide what is good or bad. So here the people's may decide. That is why I told my first child of the 7 years, she's not what is good, what is wrong. Sometimes while watching the TV after 10 o'clock, my first child may come and scold me, come and sleep, why are you watching the TV after 10 o'clock? Like that, sometimes she may come and scold me because she knows what is good, what is bad in the case of the health of the father. So you're able to understand that is for realistic principle and negotiates between the id and the environment. They're able to understand this. Yes, now I move to the ego. I already mentioned the realistic principle. Next, the third one is called superego. It developed at about the age of 6. So, and this particular the personality, it's not personality, it's like the conscious mind, no? It may control the id much, and they always believe that they always giving the much free attitude to the moral and ethics only. The superego is the final part of the personality emerging between the, I highlighted from the 6, but it may start from the year 3 to 5. So this is starting stage. Even the psychoanalytic, the psychosexual theory I'm going to talk about next, that is called Palik stage. Even the Palik stage, this is a stage of Palik stage. So they having some kind of dilemma about the Oedipus complex, the electric complex, that I may focus on the next level. The superego is a moral compass of the personality, uploading a sense of right or wrong. So they have to decide whether it's correct or wrong. Normally, they may go with the right directions only, generally. These values are initially learned from one parents. However, the superego continues to grow over time, enabling children to adopt moral standards from other people they admire, like teachers. Sometimes they may be copied from the good characteristics of the parents or the teachers. So this also may happening in the case of the superego. So superego, we may treat it as a god. How many of them seen the film of Kamalagasan? There is a film in Salamandan, I don't know in Hindi. It came in Hindi also. There is a Kamal, he acted as a one psycho. Just I'm going to read one songs in Tamil. That songs is replicate exactly the theory of the psychoanalytic theory. Kadavul paadi mirugam paadi kalandu seidha kalavena. I hope how many of them knows Tamil, understand the Tamil? Kadavul paadi mirugam paadi kalandu seidha kalavena. It means that each one's comprise of god and animals. So each one's having this some kind of animal characteristics as with the god characteristics. So it is a blending of both only the peoples like us. So in this manner that songs made by the one of the greatest lyrics writers in Tamil Nadu. ஸோ கடவுள் பாதி மிருகம் பாதி கலந்து செய்த கலவினால் உள்ளே கடவுள் வெளியே மிருகம் விளங்க முடியாத கலவினான். ஸோ இட் மீன்ஸ் அவர் இன்சைட் தெர் இஸ் எ காட், வி ஆர் ஷோவிங் சம் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் அனிமல் திங்ஸ் சம் டு அதர்ஸ். ஸோ நோ ஒன் கேன் ஐடென்டிஃபை ஹூம் ஆம் ஐ லைக் தட் தட் அ வேர்ஸ் டு பி எக்ஸ்பிளைனிங் தி தட் பர்சன்ஸ் பர்சனாலிட்டி. So if you hear the songs, the particular song, you can understand the exact theory of the Freud. So each and every line is talking about ego, superego only, the particular songs. If possible, you can hear the songs of the Alavandhan thing. So it came more than 10 years before the Kamalakasam thing. Yes, it developed at most the age of 6 and... just a moment. It is our conscious mind... what we think the difference between right or wrong, then it represents social and moral values. It is ethical and moral lamps of the personality. It is idealistic and does not care of idealistics. Alavandha, I don't know about the Hindi names, okay, Hindi name of the film, but it came to Hindi also. So like nearly three Kamalagasans, okay, one is a father Kamalagasan, he may die, then there is a one psycho Kamalagasan, one normal psycho Kamalagasan, like this, the three characteristics he may live. So that's a great film. So it's talking about the one person's how he is affected by the mentally, then how we can show this mental affection, he already affected, no, how he's replicated in the society. It's a great movie. It's talking about the personality of the people. So it's a great movie. Possibly you can see that. Now, we have to decide what kind of personality we have. Just I'm going to some kind of meaningful interpretations. Individual who have a strong or powerful ego. Suppose if your ego is dominating from your end, it means you have the balanced personality. Suppose you have the weak ego, the people's having the weak ego, or you can find some kind of persons having some kind of weak ego, they may have some kind of moral adjustment personality. Similarly, some people having, you may find a super ego. Even some of the children, you know, they may be 7 or 8 old, but the thought, no, they always going with the truth side, they always talking about moral, that kind of maturity, you can find some kind of 6 or 7 year children. So from this, we can come to the conclude that they have the neurotic personality, like they are very Gemma personality. And if the it is more powerful than ego, so they may go with delinquent only. So that is where people may come with a delinquent personality. So from the level of the it, ego and superego, we can come for conclusion about the one person personality. Yes, now I move to the Freud psychosexual stages of personality. It takes 20 minutes only, 10 to 15 minutes only. He held that the sex is the life energy. He believed that. That is why some of the psychology, they oppose his theory. Because birth from 18 months. Second stage is called anal stage. That is a particular age for the toilet training and all. Then the third stage is a very conflict stage. That is called, it's a phallic stage. That people, they may feel some kind of sexual thoughts. It's not directly that much of sexual thoughts won't be there. But they have some kind of sexual attractions. Some of the girl child, no, they may very much affection with their father. Some boy child, they may attract with the mother. So that kind of small kind of conflict may happen in the case of the sexual bias, sexual, what is this, differences. Normally the male father, girl child may like the father, boy may like the mothers, no? That kind of conflict may arise in the case of the phallic. The latency state may be after 6 years of puberty. That stage, they have some kind of confusion may arise. So whether they can play with a boy or they can play with a girl, and whether we can play with the mixture, and they don't have any intention to avoid the people, but unknowingly they may avoid some kind of some other opposite people. That is called latency stage. But in the genital stage is the adulthood stage. So they have some kind of maturity. They may mingle with the other sexual people, like male, they may interact the females very politely, very comfortably. That kind of maturity may arise in the case of genital stage. These are 5 sexual stages only he highlighted. Just I'm going to highlight one by one. And this is talking about the erogenous zones and the activity they focus in the particular stage. In the case of the oral stage, oral stage, the much preference, even they may fulfill the sexual needs from the mouth, lips, and tongue. In the case of the child, no, whenever you give any things up to the 2 years old, 2 year children, immediately they may catch or they grab these particular items. Immediately they may keep it in their mouth only, because for them the main attractive organs is mouth only. So they could not know whether that particular thing is to be eatable or not eatable, but immediately they may catch and keep the things in their mouth only. Therefore, they fulfill the desires. And see here, here he's also tried. He linked with the mouth, mouthness work in the age of up to 1.5 years, compared with the sexual things. This was also part of the sexual pleasures. Like that he interpret. Even the active focus like sucking, biting and chewing, this has happened in the case of the up to 1.5 years child. In the case of violent stage, it is for the anus. Main focus for the parents to train the children for the toilet training. So how we can sit the toilet, then how we can go to the toilet, how to use the toilet. Like this, a lot of trainings may happen. Then the third stage is phallic stage, it's a genital. Here, some kind of complex may arise, that also I'm focusing. And the latency stage, it's no erogenous zones. They don't find any kind of sexual thoughts at the particular stage. They feel they have some kind of development happen, cognitive or social development, but they could not have some kind of, sexual thought things should not be, they could not be incorporate or they could not move to the other sexual groups of people. The last one is genital, the puberty to adulthood. The development of sexual relation moving towards the intimacy about the relationship. Here, the good kind of relationship may happen in the age of the genitals. We will go one by one. So, in the case of oral stage, birth from 1.5 years, I already mentioned that pleasure is focused on the mouth. So, what are things you are giving immediately, they may keep in the mouth only. The eating and the pleasures derive from the sucking. Normally, the behaviors is sucking is the main behavior for them. And play a large part of the baby's first year of life. So most of the children life up to 1.5 years, most of the time they used to suck any nipples or the thumb. Even some of the children having the thumb nipping habits are there. Nowadays we cannot find that kind of things. Previously when I was the 10th standard under, I can cross lot of children, they always keeping the thumb sucking, and that behavior is there. But now I could not found that kind of character now. It's good. At around 1 year of age, the babies are weaned from the bottle, because after the 1 year, the mother feeding won't be there. They may train for the some kind of bottle feeding or other feedings they may incorporate into that. So according to the Freud, and even this kind of behavior, no, the oral stage behavior, it may leads in the case of the adulthood stage also, like smoking, drinking. Some people are overeating, some people are always biting the hand, nails. So these are the continuous characteristics in the age of the oral stage. So this is way the Freud may interpret like this. So an adult who smokes, drinks, overeats or bites her nails is fixated in the oral stage of her psychosexual development only, or his psychosexual development only. So in this manner, the childhood to adulthood. The second stage is called anal stage. So this is stage main for the toilet training only. After passing through the oral stage, children enter the Freud termed as anal stage in the year 1-3. In this stage, the children experience pleasure in the bowel and bladder movement. So it makes sense that the conflict in the stage is over the toilet training. I will mention the Freud suggests that the success of on stage dependent on how parents handling the toilet training. The problem with some of the children, they may urinating in the bed itself, because the parents not doing the proper training, toilet training. If you are giving the proper training in the toilet, the children won't go for the urinary in the bed and also the problem with the parents only. The Freud apparently suggests that the success of the anal stage depends on how the parent and the toilet training, and parent who offer praise and rewards encourage positive rewards results and can help the children feel competent. For example, suppose you can give some kind of rewards you can give to the children. Suppose your children having the habits to urine in that bed, in the sense, as a parent, we can tell them, if you are not going for 1 week, I can give some kind of ice cream or some kind of sweets. Like that, you can motivate them to stop that kind of wrong toilet training in the bed. In this manner, we can control the children. That is called anal stage, the toilet training. And the third stage is a pallic stage. This is a very conflict stage. Particularly the male student, male childs are attacked from the mother. Similarly, the female childs, they may attack with the fathers. This is the third stage of psychosexual development in the age 3 to 6 years. Corresponding to the age when the children become aware of their bodies, they may understand the basic difference between the male body and female body. They can recognize the things also. And the erogenous of the zone in this stage is a genital. Conflict arises when the child feels to desire for the opposite sex parent only, and jealous and hatred towards the same sex parent. Sometimes the boy, he don't like to speak father, because the same sex group, they don't have that much of closeness. Sometimes they may feel while seeing the father, the boy is seeing the father and all. That is the stage. But as a father, what you can do, we can give some kind of, for example, my son is always against me in the age, the particular group, particular age means. We can add some kind of mother characters, mother activities, like we can feed the food for him. Like that, if you convert his feeling, he may treat it as that father also may come as a mother back things. So we have to understand immediate some kind of difference you may find out from the children's. Immediately you can recognize and give some kind of remedy in this. Otherwise, it leads the children's personality in the other in the childhood itself weak causes in this, because this stage is a very conflict. It may start from 3 to 6 years, because they knows the difference between the boy and girls based on the body structure, and apparently they have some kind of close attraction with the opposite sex. That's why I use the word Oedipus conflict. And if you look onto the book of the Interpretation of Dreams, he may highlight a lot of things, the Oedipus complex as well as the Electra complex. Then Oedipus complex or Oedipus complex represent the boy becomes attracted to his mother and fears the father. So he may fear the father. Similarly, the female child may be attracted by the father. That is called as the Electra conflict, according to him. Then the next stage is called latency stage. So the following the paric stage, the psychosexual development is a period known as the latency, the fourth stage called latency. This year's 6 years to puberty stage up to this may lead. This period is not considered a stage because sexual feelings are dormant as the children focus on other pursuits such as school friendship, habits and sports. So they may close with some kind of grouping like my neighbor friend, my classmates, my bench mates, my sportsmen, like that, they may get some kind of generosity may arise there. And children generally engage in activity with peers of the same sex. The particular latency stage, they have some kind of bias happen. So the male may play with males only, females may play with female, like that, they have some kind of negative notions. That is why they may always depends on play with the same sex people only. This is called the stage for the gender role identity, particularly. The last stage is called genital. This is stage some kind of maturity happened from the both male and female. Boy and girl now feels to strange feeling or strong sensations in the genital and attraction towards the members of the opposite sex. In this particular stage, there's some kind of attraction may arise because generally the sexual attractions may either. That sexual attractions, it may, the male may very much happy to speak female. Similarly, the females may talk to the male. That kind of attraction may arise in this particular period. And in this stage, there is a sexual reawakening as the insidious urges of the resurfaces. The young persons redirect the urges to others, more socially acceptable partners. And people in this stage have the mature sexual interest. With for the Freud means a strong desire for the opposite sex, according to Freud only. Then individual who successfully completed the previous stage, reacting the genitive stage with no fixations, are said to be well-planned and healthy adults. So in this stage, as a parent, we have to direct them properly. Otherwise, this behavior also may lead in different manner. So as a parent, even the teacher fraternity, we have to observe the people's adolescence, adulthood, and we can give the proper proper guidance for them in this particular stage. Because this stage, most of the time, the peer group domination may be there. If the peer group's members not good, that peer group personality influence may affect the person's influence. So be cautious in that. So I'm going to conclude my today's presentation. So in what way this kind of theory may help in the sense, it has given a good method for the study of behavior. It has provided good therapy, you know, particularly even we could not find the problems while delivering the class in the adulthood groups. Adolescent groups. Because the adolescents, the peoples may influence lot of background variables may influence the person's personality. So we have to find this kind of theory may helping to understand the person's personality. Apparently, we can provide some kind of therapy also. Understand the maladaptive behavior, the approaching to proper extracurricular activity. Sometimes some people's, you know, very aggressive characteristics in the case of Eden. So that kind of characteristics we can direct into the some kind of extracurricular curricular activities. So then they may go for the normal beings and all. So the Sigmund Freud presented for the first comprehensive of the personality. He also the first to recognize that much of our mental life takes place outside of our conscious awareness. Freud also proposed three components of our personality. That's why I already mentioned ego, superego. The job of the ego is to balance the sexual and aggressive drives of the id with the moral ideal of the superego. Freud also said the personality develops through the series of psychosexual stages. That only we discussed. The stages names aral, oral, anal, phallic, latent, and genital. In each stage, pleasure focus on specific erogenous zones. Failure to resolve the stages can lead one to become the fixated in the stage. So leading the unhealthy personality traits, successful resolutions of the stage leads to healthy habit. So in this particular, the five stages, if they're not getting the proper guidance from the parents, it may affect the high level in the personalities of the children. So be cautious, suppose if you have the children, be cautious while handling the particular group of people. And these peoples may call as Neo-Freudian. I already mentioned that. One is called Carl Jung, other one is called Alfred Adler, then Karen Hardy. They are the great followers of the Freudian. But apparently they are opposing some kind of basic ideas of the Freud. So therefore they are called as Neo-Freudian. So thank you so much. So today I'm discussing about the psychoanalytic theory. There the Freud is citing ego, superego. Then after this, I led the presentations related to psychosexual theory. He's made the five stages, that is aral, anal, phallic, latent, and genital. So I hope you understand how we can interpret the people's personality once you observe the people's in the sense. So I hope you may understand it. Thank you all.